So, the guest room is right here. Make yourself at home. I just need to talk to Ryan for a moment. Can you show me that?
Revolting.
I think it's sweet.
Please, they can't possibly be that much in love. They just met 4 months ago.
Five.
Ugh.
Enough already. I'm Joe.
Have fun, babe.
I miss you already.
Miss you too. Listen. You let me hold something? You know, they cut my hours at work, and you know how they about to jack the prices at the club. Surprise. You got me?
Something about that guy, just too damn slick.
Yeah, he does seem a bit slippery.
Did you see his big old muscle head? Looks all roided out.
You ought to know, Kyle.
Oh, baby, don't put that on me. This body here, 100% natural, baby. Get out.
I never would have pegged that for Magnus's type. Looks like he can lift a ton, but can't spell it.
Okay.
Shh, quiet, you guys. Okay. So where to first?
Sightseeing.
Oh.
Wow.
I know, right?
Just imagine Langston Hughes himself sitting right up in that window, creating some masterpiece.
What happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun, or fester like a sore and then run?
Imagine all the dick he must have gotten up here in Harlem. I mean, have you seen the Fine Brothers walking around with no shirts on?
You see, this is why I couldn't live in New York. I would be pregnant inside of a week.
Wait to ruin a moment, Joey.
This is sacred hollow ground for us black gay men.
Yeah.
And women.
Sebastian is right. This is a part of our history. Look at it.
Okay, so we've seen it. Now, can we check this off our black gay history bucket list?
And can the next stop on the Harriet Tubman Underground Railroad please involve a cocktail? Because I'm gonna need my next teachable moments be brought to me by absolutes.
Okay.
Can we at least take a picture?
I got it.
No, Kyle. We all have to be in it.
You.
What up?
You take this picture for us?
I got you.
Hands off, guys, he's mine.
All right, 1, 3. 1, 2.
My booty hole just quivered.
3.
See, graduation hasn't mellowed his libido any.
I don't get it. How come he's the one who always pulls?
You don't get it. Really?
So he's got a few muscles. I can walk outside, spit, and hit a dude with muscles. Dime a dozen.
Not even.
Where are you going?
Bathroom. Mm-hmm.
Sluts.
Something's never changed.
Got to get laid this weekend.
Oh, me too.
You know you could have gone with the others. I wouldn't have minded.
It's cool. I wanted to see where you work.
You mean you didn't want to be around Kyle in his latest pool?
Mr. Grayson, I'm sure I don't know what you're talking about. Okay. If I tell you something, you gotta promise not to say anything.
Have I ever said anything?
Since I got back from Paris, mm-hmm. Kyle and I have been talking a lot.
You've been to LA?
No, we talk on the phone, we text, we Skype practically every day for months. And I think, well, I'm sure that he's waiting on me to make the first move. So I decided this weekend, I'm gonna do it.
You gonna tell him you love him?
Like him. I like him.
Fine. You gonna tell him you've been liking him since freshman year?
It's not so much what I'm gonna tell him as what I'm gonna give him. My special gift? I want a girl, I call it my flower?
Sweet baby Jesus and the gay unicorn, you're a virgin? Still?
What do you mean, still? You think we'd had sex and I told you?
9 months in Paris, the most romantic city in the world. I just figured some French man would have plucked that flower by now.
I was saving it for someone special. And that special one is Kyle.
How are you planning to give away your virginity to Kyle when he's probably down at that bar right now seducing that random he pulled off the street in front of Langston Hughes Brownstone?
Kyle is who he is. I'm not trying to change him. And it doesn't matter what he does before he's with me. Once I give myself to him, the whole game changes.
I just don't want to see you get hurt.
And I love you for that. But my mind's made up. It's Kyle. And it's this weekend.
Any other way, 'cause when you squeeze my hand, I know that you've been worth the worry. And I wouldn't have him. Well, any other way, 'cause when you're on my mind, I ain't nothing but
pride. Okay, I've been giving it some thought, and I think I know why I'm not getting laid.
Why? Share the knowledge.
Because I assume every guy is full of it and or not really interested in me, so I don't even bother trying.
I just don't have any game when it comes to females. Maybe I shouldn't have spent my entire undergraduate career hanging around with a bunch of gay guys.
Practice on me. Cat got your tongue? I get it. You're one of those intellectuals. Probably in some PhD program at some fancy school. Harvard?
Yale.
Right. You probably used to those dowdy, ultra-feminist chicks. Kind of think it's a crime to look sexy and show some skin. God forbid you be smart and have a nice rack. Listen, if you really want to get laid, as opposed to sitting here writing a dissertation about it, you gotta get yourself out there, loosen up a little bit. A pretty girl like you having trouble getting laid, that's all on you.
This view is stunning. You get to wake up to this every day.
Thanks to my parents.
How many units are occupied?
We went on the market in January. We're about 80% sold. My dad keeps warning me not to get too comfortable, but I think they're gonna give me this place as a graduation gift when I officially become a doctor. Sweet baby Jesus and the gay unicorn. You got a tramp stamp?
Oh, come on.
Joey Paul Prince, are you kidding me?
Come on. Tiger.
Don't give him a pass on this. Tramp stamps lead to one place and one place only.
XG.
Well, I was gonna say the stripper pole, but same difference.
Actually, it's not the same. Mine was better.
How was yours better?
Mine was more 21st century.
No, it wasn't. And who cares? The point is, tramp stamps are a slippery slope to God only knows what.
Let it go. Just let it go.
Do you like it, really? Because I'm thinking about getting another one.
What are you gonna get this time?
Don't say stars. Just don't say stars.
A bunch of stars.
I quit.
Okay, pre-party cocktails are served. Whiskey sours, Ryan's recipe.
Kyle, ain't nobody online but a bunch of whores.
That is not true. There are guys on here who are not just looking for easy sex.
Really? Because all I can see is a bunch of dicks and assholes.
Ryan and I met online. What's wrong with that?
Nothing, per se. It's just surprising. You make no secret of your uber-traditional plans to find the perfect husband, get the perfect career, the 2.5 kids. I just wouldn't think a site like this is the place for that.
Yeah, but if I'm on there, why wouldn't there be other guys like me?
I think what Langston is trying to say.
How do you know you can trust Ryan when you just met him 4 months ago on some hookup site?
The same guys online are the same guys we see at clubs, the same guys we see at prides. Kyle, you're on there. Are you trustworthy? How do you know you can trust anybody until you can trust them? Whether you meet them online, the club, the gym, church.
If you meet them at church, then you know you cannot trust them.
Okay.
Joey, you know what I mean. The point is no matter how much vetting you do, there's always a leap of faith involved. I choose to take that leap. Besides, we both deleted our profiles when we decided to become boyfriends.
Hopeless romantic. I love it.
Ha. Speak of the devil. I'll take this outside.
Is that who I think it is?
I wasn't sure, but your reaction just showed it. And that's not it. Look what he wrote.
Oh, no trifle ass.
I just made a batch of your delicious whiskey sours.
Babe, I better go. I love you too. All right. Bye.
What's up? You guys out of cocktails already? You need me to make another batch?
We need to show you something.